Well, good morning and welcome to our ramble today. We're starting a ramble, as you can see, at Beetham Corn Mill. There's 14 of us out on a very blustery day, but fortunately there's no rain as yet. So we're hoping for the best, and we're just getting ready and off we go up the big hill. Well, we've now reached the Dallam Park area, just gone through the gate, and hopefully we might see some deer as we go on our way. Oh yes, that looks like some deer there. A crowd of them. We're far enough away from them not to bother them, so they won't start running off. Had to turn the sound down on the actual movie because it's that loud with the wind blowing. So you just have to put it with my voice today. I just saw them cheap off, so we decided we'd better run together. We're just going on to the brow of the hill and then down the other side. We should see Dallam Hall in the bottom soon. Down on the footpath that leads out onto the Sandside road. The stag there. There's actually four of them, but we can only just see three. The other one's just round the other side. There we are, crossing the road that leads to Sandside. We've just come out of Dallam Park. Tide's on its way in. It seems a bit rough as well in place there. And this was the old railway line that we're on now. Come on, you two travellers, let's have you. I'm just looking towards Arnside there. And here we are coming off for our coffee break, and this is like an industrial estate that's been built not that long ago. A business park. Coffee time. Three or four of us went into the garage and had our coffee in there. It's a bit less blowy. Now we've set off again and we're aiming for Storth now. That's George just having a pat at the horses. I hope you don't forget that stick, whoever's it is. I hope you're going to put it back afterwards.
This is coming up to dinner time now.
I hope you're going to put it back afterwards.
These four, I'll just listen. A pheasant there. Now making our way to Fairy Steps. Is it? Our fun and games going up here. And George and Frank have made it up to now. They say that if you can get up there without touching the sides, then you can make a wish and it should come true. But as you can see, I don't think there's much chance of that. Not particularly with our men, anyway. Come on, David, never mind taking pictures. Let's have you up here. You're holding them all back. Come on, you can do it. Breathe in a bit.
Ah, well done, you're up now.
Almost there. Will you take a picture of me? So lift your hat up and then we can see who it is we're taking a picture of. Alan's managing with his bag on his back as well. He must be a bit thinner than us. Or a smaller bag. Maybe that's what it is. And that's Peter's turn. Oh, this is Derek coming up. Closely followed by Frank behind him. And then David Slater. As you can see, it's a bit tight. Oh, Hey, we're here. Good lad, Frank. David seems to be doing quite well. And Arthur's next. Very good, we're all made. I'll just have a bit of a breather here before we get going again. Just looking over to the estuary there, you can see the Sandside viaduct. Just looking over towards Sandside there, and now we're on our way again. Making our way back to Beetham. Getting near to the end of the walk now, you can see Beetham village and the mill's just in the distance. So I hope you've enjoyed rambling with us today, and we'll hopefully see you next week. And we're going to go to Leck and Tunstall. So it's the end of the walk, so thank you for watching, we'll see you next week. So bye for now.